So according to that, heavy lead, there are two types, terrestrial and aquatic. Terrestrial and aquatic. Terrestrial means the plants which grow on land are known as terrestrial plants. That includes plants in plains, plants in hilly areas, plants in coastal areas. So these three points I have done in the previous class, isn't it? So already 3 points are over. So let me move on to the fourth point, that is plants in deserts. So let us see how the plants in desert adapt themselves. Okay, children. So how the temperature in desert, children? The temperature is hot and dry, isn't it? The temperature is hot and dry here, and also rainfall is scanty. Scanty means what? That means in the textbook, insufficient in quantity, insufficient in quantity. So in this area, the temperature is high and they are insufficient of amount of water, okay? Insufficient in quantity. So how the plants adapt themselves in this area? Let us learn about them. So some plants grow in deserts where very little water is available, children. So they use very little water, and also they store water in their stems. They store water in their stems. They do not lose water. Why they do not lose water? Because they have small and spine-like leaves. Okay, and as a children, their stems perform the function of leaves. Their stems perform the function of leaves by expanding and bearing the green colored chlorophyll by the process of photosynthesis. Examples of such plants are cactus and dates. Cactus and dates. Okay. So the cactus, you can see in the picture here how the cactus is. They store the water in the stem, children, and also you can see the spines on that stem. You can see now in the picture here. So they store water in their stems and perform the functions of leaves. Okay, children. So let me move on to the marshy areas. In marshy areas, how the soil is? The soil is clay with lot of water. In marshy areas, the soil is clay with lot of water in it, and there is very little air between the soil particles. Okay, there is very little air between the soil particles. The plants growing in these areas have roots. The plants growing in these areas have roots that grow above the soil. That grow above the soil. Why the roots grow above the soil? To breathe in. Okay, to breathe in. And also they are known as breathing roots. They are also known as breathing roots. You can see this in mangroves. Okay, it is in your textbook. You can see the picture here. Above the soil. Okay, children. So next is plants in grasslands. Plants in grasslands. Grasslands receive very less rainfall. Grasslands receive very less rainfall. The plants are adapted to develop deep roots. The plants are adapted to develop deep roots. Why it happens means because it can absorb the water from the soil. That is why the plants are adapted to develop deep roots. Okay, children. And also, the large area of grasslands covered with grass and white flowers. Examples of such plants are foxtail and red grass. Okay, sorry, red grass. Red grass. And foxtail are the examples of such plants. Foxtails are the white flowers. So next is plants in rainforest. So how this thing is here? It receives very high rainfall here. Okay, rainforest receive very heavy rainfall here. And then how the plants grow here? The have thick crown on it. Has thick crown. It is also known as wet and hot. So wet and hot forest. It is also known as wet and hot forest. Even short trees and climbers also grow in this areas. So examples are palm and orchids. Examples are palm and orchids. Okay, children. So here we conclude my class. So we learned the terrestrial plants. Terrestrial plants means what? The plants which grow on land or known as terrestrial plants. We can use plants in plains, plants in hilly areas, plants in coastal areas. How plants adapt themselves in these areas? So that about that we learn, isn't it? And also today we learn plants in deserts, plants in marshy areas, plants in grasslands, plants in rainforests. So we learn about the terrestrial plants. In the next class, we are going to learn about the aquatic plants. Aquatic means water plants. So how the plants are going to adapt themselves, we are going to learn in the next class, that is floating plants, fixed plants and submerged plants. Okay children, let me wind up my class here. Meet you in the next class. Thank you children.